what I represent. And for a while, since like 81, I believe, the inception of our gangs was like 76 and 77. And then we was cool neighborhood friends and everything. And then, you know, as we grew, it became separateness. And, you know, we had a rivalry going from like 1981 all the way to like somewhere in 95, 96, when myself and some of the older guys, like my homeboy Lottie and Catman from his hood, okay, and a couple of more participants, we got together in the neighborhood and figured out how to quell all the violence, you know.
Okay. Yeah, that's hot. Y'all did a good job on this.
And yes, we got the phone.
One of these guys.
Speaking of Snoop.
Wow, wow.
That's right. Snoop is on the phone.
What's up, Wiggle?
Church, what's up, players?
Church.
Hey, ladies.
Hey, man. How you doing?
You coming on too, right, Snoop?
we like the group and the song.
Oh, y'all like that?
Yeah. I'll try to get in the video.
Hey, we got another video we get ready to shoot in about 2 weeks. We love to have y'all in it.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Wait a minute. I'm not wearing no panties.
I can't wear no G-string. While we got Snoop and all you guys, what we've been talking about the show is the N-word, the use of the word nigga in all these rap songs and comics and our everyday life. Would you like to comment on that, anyone?
I would.
Okay.
Well, over the past 6 to 8 months, you know, from one of the homies from the Bay Area, Mac Sean, we've been using the word nephew, you know, instead of that word nigga. We've been using nephew or, you know, nizzle or, you know, just something to run away from that word because, you know, we don't like it, but it's something that was bred in us and we trying to shake it. And as we get older, we get wiser. So we trying to put, you know, more of those words in our music instead of that N-word. But, I mean, it's not all the way out of us, but the point is we making an effort and we trying.
And Snoop, okay, you guys, you know what? You guys are the ones that can help it change to something else.
So
because
expound further on that, you know, I've joined the Nation of Islam myself. Mm-hmm. I was guided by the divine spirit to shed all of my negative behavior, my negative projections towards my black brothers and sisters as well as humanity, you know, for the fact that, you know, the world and society is becoming so loose and irresponsible that through our music, we commonly, naturally would give the wrong message because that's what society feeds on. Like you turn on the news, you see violence, right, violence.
And
then you see a human interest
too
story at after
exactly
5 segments of violence. So I just want people to know.
But you know, a lot of white people, at least other people, feel that they use the word nigga for their own entertainment. It's like, mm-hmm, it's so, you know what I'm saying, for their entertainment.
But I like what Snoop said. No, nephew, using other words.
Yeah. Brother. And brother is always
brother,
a good word.
Brother's good. But brother, in the rap song,
sucker.
People are going to adapt to whatever has changed. That's what I'm saying. I know the word isn't going to go. That's what I was saying earlier. I know the word's not going to go, and they're trying to find new ways of new meanings for it. Yeah. But you can't ignore the meaning that came with it from whence we came. You can't ignore that, and it's a painful word.
It is by choice, and he made his choice. He found his road. Everybody does that. When you guys mentioned those gangs you made, I was over in the hood, and they come up on me. They said, they're just rolling 60s, you know. And I said, well, I'm from the roller derby. So the niggas started laughing. That's what I said to them. So they laughed. They said, okay, fine. But I remember Richard Pryor used that word on that nigga's crazy.
Right.
You know,
before,
and he used
before
it.
He
and
did
he,
that
then
stuff.
He went to Africa, and he came back, and he said that he didn't see any niggas in Africa, so he's going to stop using it. But this was prior to when he made millions of dollars off of using it.
Is that Paul Mooney?
Yes, sir.
Brother Mooney, what's happening, player?
How you doing?
That's too funny.
Man, I can't see you, but I feel you. I heard that voice. I said, that's classic right there.
He know that voice. Well, what
but
about
no,
you?
But it's you know, so it, everything's evolving, and mm-hmm, everybody's using, that's why they said the N-word, they want to take the pressure off, and mm-hmm, people create new words, and the white folks created the race card, you know, that comes from the OJ trial. I didn't even know we had a race card. I'm trying to get my MasterCard. Did I say Master or Master?
I don't know.
Goldie, what's your feeling?
I mean, you know, it's carved, you know. It's just something that's out there, and you have to, you know, try to find a way how you can just, you know, translate it a different, you know, in a different tone, so it won't just be looked at as like, oh, same thing. Mm-hmm. He don't care, or, you know, we just keep on creating new words for that word right there. I don't too much care for.
What's really important too, and you touched on this, is that hip hop is surpassing rock and roll. I mean, hip hop is controlling the culture now, which is a wonderful thing.
It's controlling the world.
Exactly.
Yeah, because I saw Pygmies singing.
Yes.
Okay, and you know, most of the people that listen to rap or hip hop are non-blacks.
And young
people. So we are touching
and
that.
Young people who don't understand the struggle of the 60s. Therefore, so they need to be educated.
You have to have someone in a prominent position.
Bam.
Right.
To turn their own self away.
Exactly.
From the negativity of the word.
Like Snoop and yourselves.
Exactly. Yeah, but on that same note, if the rap getting criticized for what we don't do and start getting credit for what we do, mm-hmm. it would be better, because a lot of good things that we do a lot of good things that never get no attention or no spotlight, but you don't hear us complaining about it because that's in our heart. But at the same time, if we had, you know, shows like y'all that would always support us and let us bring our views to life, you know what I'm saying, then it would be, people would understand us a little bit more and understand that we are making a difference, because we're not killing or doing none of the things that we could be doing. We actually give an opportunity by opening up doors in this rap world.
Or the things That's they think right. you're doing.
Right.
They still have this bad connotation of rappers and, mm-hmm. you know, gangs and just black people in general in the hood. So it's nice right. to see that you're
but
trying
see,
to make a change.
But this whole thing that bothers me about gangs, it's like, this is old. This is not new. We grew up in a society that worships gangs. I mean, it started with Al Capone and all those white folks. And the massacre, you know, the St. Valentine's massacre, the drive-bys, that all started with white folks.
Yeah.
Up to now, and our society, our youth was copying that. And it's like we worship the wrong things. It's like this HBO show that's on, this Sopranos. People mm-hmm. worship that. See, I don't mind if it's you do gladiators and things that are dead and gone. But these people still are living, these mafia people. I'm not impressed with them. I'm offended by it. I don't show it in my house, because they are murderers. They're in child pornography. They're laundering money. They're selling drugs. They're doing all this. And they're being worshipped, the best show, the best that. That stuff is disgusting, because what it does, it glorifies that. It makes people want to be that. It does. Mm-hmm. And HBO well, does that, and they say they want to.
See you on another show of Old Drama now. Don't forget you coming on the show.
Church.
I'll see you later on tonight at the studio, homie.
Church.
All right.
I'll see you later on at the studio. We'll be right back.